5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, folks, to another episode of the Going Downhill Fast podcast. I'm the guest host. No, I'm not a host. I'm the podcaster, Justin.
I'm Fat Mike.
I'm Skinny Mike.
We're kind of both Skinny Mikes.
Sure. We'll go with that. Okay. Anyway, how was your guys' week?
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Ridiculous.
You changed your shirts. I went
camping this weekend.
Really? Did you wake up in the middle of the night with your pants down around your ankles and your asshole all greased up? Yeah.
And I was the only one there. So it's confusing.
You were like, I went with a guy named...
I did see a bear walking away with a cigarette in his mouth, though.
Oh, your buddy that you nicknamed Bear?
Bear.
The bear?
Bear, yeah.
He's a hairy gentleman.
And, you know, and the guy in that bike gang, Reza Harley, you know, Bear. That guy.
Sure wasn't Ron Jeremy? Ron
Jeremy. Could have been.
Were you bleeding?
Yeah.
Well, okay, it's probably Ron Jeremy.
That's what I'm thinking.
You know, they don't even use him for porns anymore. He takes it as he can get it.
He's been charged with sexual assault or something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, he got into some trouble there.
With some campers?
Yeah. It's a class action lawsuit, and I'm leading it. So.
Really?
I knew it.
I just signed a class action lawsuit form for Facebook for sharing my information. I'm expecting my $6 within the next few months. I'm dead serious. I got a notification because I was part of Facebook between whatever 2010 to 2011 to fill out my stuff.
Well, see, now you can retire. Wow. So it's good.
So the lawyers will get $38.5 million, and I'm going to get $6.
Happy retirement, buddy.
Yep.
More than me. I should have been on that too.
You can go Google it. You know, they have it even if you weren't included. I've been on
Facebook. Can I still get my $6?
I haven't got any. I just filled out the thing today saying I want to be part of it.
How long? I think I've been on Facebook.
I've been off Facebook for about 7, 8 years.
FB from 07 or 08. Remember MySpace?
I still got MySpace up. I just went on there and took all my pictures off recently.
I forgot my password.
I got mine. You want to pull my MySpace up? Sure.
I haven't checked out MySpace in a
while. You know, I got a friend on there, Tom. Oh, we go way back.
Is your number one
Tom
fan.
And everybody goes way back.
Tom is your number one fan.
You know what? Tom never violated my privacy. That's why I appreciate Tom.
He never replied to me, ever.
Unlike the Zuck.
He never sold all my info.
Yeah.
He never banned me.
Yeah.
I wasn't on Facebook long enough to be put in jail. I mean, I was on it for 4 or 5 years probably, but it's been a while.
I saw this meme. I quit. 24 hours in jail from Facebook from posting a meme that I got from Facebook.
Yeah. And you posted that shit like 8 years ago, and they're going back to.
Oh, well, then in that case, they're probably looking at my shit right now. They're like, well, it's a good thing you're not allowed on anymore. You're permanent 86th from this platform, which would be fine with me.
Zucked.
I don't care.
Zucked.
Yeah. Zucked. Well, whatever. It's the way the magic of social media works these days.
Yep.
It's freedom speech as long as you
where are you
agree
going,
with
Al?
The agenda.
I need something to drink.
You look very dehydrated.
Yeah.
You should probably get something to drink.
I was going
to
say, you got to start bulking back up there, buddy. You're looking a little thin in the skin.
Yeah, except for your gut. Yeah, so I was actually, funny thing, you know how you get random thoughts in your head once in a while? I know you don't very often, Mike. But
no, I don't. I don't think about anything.
So I wonder if people, because of this lawsuit thing, you know how the cigarette companies got sued because of cancerous deaths and stuff?
Yeah.
Could Facebook and other social medias get sued for the mental illness and people committing suicide?
Good point.
That they're causing?
Hmm. Comment below.
That's
a good point.
You know what I mean? Because they know, they've done the research, they've put out tidbits where they said that they...
Yeah. Oh, it definitely causes psychological damage.
Especially for teens and whatnot.
Yeah,
so they know, just absolutely. Like cigarette companies knew and they hid the information.
That is true.
So could...
They know what they're doing to keep you on there, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, could you sue the social media?
Mm,
for deaths and or mental health issues?
I'll just call a lawyer. Better call Sal.
Better call Saul.
I think it's only a matter of time, right, before somebody does it anyway.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. Come on, guys. Let's band together.
I mean, look at us.
Yeah. Look at do I look normal to you? Shit.
You make me feel normal and I'm not.
Yeah, I know. So anyway, what do we got?
I don't know. What want to go off our topics? Oh, so this is one. Yeah, you think I'm not doing my homework, but this is one I heard of when I was on vacation. You know what the Georgia guidestones are?
Oh yes.
It's basically it's supposed to be like it's kind of like a Stonehenge. These no one knows who put them up.
I know
monoliths, and it's supposed to be like for humanitarian reasons, right? Like it's up there. There's like words of enthusiasm, you know. But
the
like
psychotic freaking shit
for humanity. But there's one.
The Earth needs 500,000 people.
We had to.
500 million.
What does it actually say? Well, the maximum of 500 million.
Something like that.
People.
There's a lot of anti-human shit.
But it's supposed to be of humanity is why it was put up.
So it was put up by Microsoft?
Probably.
Well, there were cameras covering what took place. Well, what happened to those guidestones?
So just recently, so no one knows what happened. One of them fell over.
I thought they said they blew up.
Well, okay, I'm getting there. So one of them fell over, was all cracked and stuff, and the thing maybe a car backed into it or something. I don't know if there's cameras.
It have to be an awfully fucking big car that's very heavy.
I don't know. Are there cameras on it? Like 24 hours?
There are cameras.
Oh, so they probably do know what happened. I don't know exactly. I'm not reading that star here in front of me, but they actually blew it up. Mm-hmm. The rest of it for safety reasons, because when that one monolith fell, the rest of them were unstable, so it's gone.
That's the humanity's gonna fall. That was the indicator.
No,
yeah,
dude, that thing was anti-humanity.
Done.
We're done.
Yeah,
God struck it down.
Aliens That's are coming happened. Down.
Yeah, well, I really hope so.
When the pyramid falls in Giza,
you know, I'm like,
no, this shit was put up in like 1980. This isn't anything super ultra historical.
No one knows who put it up.
Yeah, but even the pyramids at one time were only 30 years old.
Yeah,
like, well, they aren't that big.
They
deal.
Weren't struck down by lightning then. This shit got hit by lightning and fucked it all up. Something.
Yeah, I'm trying to see what was actually written on the.
We gave some gun rights back to some people in some really liberal states. We overturned Roe v. Wade. God struck down the guidestones. He's getting pissed. That's what's happening.
Okay, so this is what's on the guidestone. Maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. Guide reproduction wisely. Improve fitness and diversity. Unite humanity with a living new language. Rule passion, faith, tradition, and all things with tempered reason. Protect people and nations with fair laws and just courts. Let all nations rule internally, resolving external disputes in a world court. Avoid petty laws and useless officials. Balance personal rights with social duties. Prize truth, beauty, love, seeking harmony with the infinite. Be not a cancer on the earth. Leave room for nature. Leave room for nature. So it's supposed to be messages about humanity.
Yeah.
But that very first, maintain humanity under 500 million.
It's demonic, dude. It's freaking globalist bullshit.
I'm for cutting down the population.
Yeah. Like, you and Bill Gates.
Yeah. Like what Bill Burr said, just, you know, take out 80% of the population.
Well, okay.
They say the population is going to start declining at some point here.
Yeah.
If we're going to do a Bill Burr style, then let's go blow up some freaking. No, yeah.
That Roe v. Wade has been overturned, it's going to blow up.
No, I don't think so. But let's go hunt cruise ships. Just like Bill Burr said.
Okay.
That was a funny bit. No, I mean, the Georgia guidestones were a lot of things, but one of them is not good. It's not good.
It was misleading. It's supposed to be about humanity, but it's nothing about humanity.
Yeah, commandment one is humanity. You know what? It does work. Ten Commandments. And I'm only saying this, even if you're an atheist, even if you're an agnostic, you got to at least admit that trying to abide by them, which nobody can successfully, at least trying, is a decent philosophy for life. So, yeah. I mean, our court system was built off of them. I'm not saying you got to, you know, believe in everything in the Bible, but I'm just saying, if you just look at the Ten Commandments as a standalone.
I can't get around the seventh commandment. Thou shalt not get fries with your meal. I gotta get fries with my meal. I have to.
Do they have potatoes in Hawaii?
Thou shalt not get fries with your meal.
Thus the belly.
Are there potatoes in Hawaii?
The Buddha belly.
At the Safeway.
But anyway.
There's a Safeway in Hawaii?
Yeah.
But don't they have more culturally appropriate names?
Just one Safeway. It's called Steve, brah. Safe, bro.
I like it.
There's different. There's a Foodland market, which has been there for years. I think it's owned by one of the major supermarkets here, though.
Kroger.
Maybe.
Great Value.
Kroger or the Anderson Safeway.
You think they would just have one called the Piggly Wiggly. That would be kind of appropriate.
The pineapple pizza. They'll go out of business.
The Hawaiian pizza.
The Piggly Wiggly. They have a Foodland and a Times supermarket, which I don't see. They might have those on the West Coast. Maybe a Times supermarket on the West Coast, but I haven't seen them here. You know, it's like Florida. I have a Publix supermarket. See them all over when I was in Florida.
People are gaga over the Publix too.
Yeah. This was good. I guess the pastries, Publix pastries.
I have no idea.
And like what you said, the Piggly Wiggly down south, right? Yeah, the Piggly Wiggly. Oh.
Tom Thumb.
On the west, on the southwest, they have Fry's. Fry's grocery stores, right? And what's the one?
I always thought it was Fry's Electronics.
Fry's, or maybe it is Fry's Electronics.
Same thing.
Same thing.
And there's one.
It's a Super Fry's. We know on the West Coast, we had Fry's Electronics when I was younger.
Anderson's?
When I was a kid.
In the Southwest. Was it Anderson's Supermarkets?
Southwest.
I thought they had one in Arizona. Anderson's, I think it was called. Oh, Smith's. That's Smith's.
Maybe it's Johnson's.
Maybe. Well, I think I have Anderson. I think I made that shit up. But they have Smith. They have a Smitty's.
This fucking this whole podcast is a lie.
No, they have a Smitty's and they have a Smith's, right? Grocery stores.
Okay, I've heard of Smitty's, I think, but anyway.
Okay, so
fucking grocery stores are all over the country. Yeah, it's really crazy.
Oh, potatoes in Hawaii. Yes, they do. Yeah, potatoes.
They grow them?
They can. They're not indigenous or whatever the word is. They were brought over.
Hawaii-Ireland?
from old Hawaiian.
The Hawaii-Ireland Island?
Yeah.
Down there?
You know, that potato king that brought it over, you know, Okeanu brought it over from Hawaii-Ireland, you know. He's actually Irish, right? Irish Hawaiian.
Who?
Keanu Reeves. I think the Reeves is Irish. And Keanu.
No, that's definitely Hawaiian.
The Reeves.
Yeah. Of course.
The Keanu's Irish. Yeah, McKeanu. McUnton. That's my name.
Nice.
Irish.
McQuinton.
McQuinton. Yeah. O'Unton.
O'Unton.
Excuse me.
Oh, jeez. I threw it.
Anyway, so that's my story. So
okay, and you're sticking to it. All right, what's next, man? Come on, let's liven this fucking party up. What do you got for us today, Charlie?
What do you got?
I got trivia if you guys want to play it, but
we can play some trivia.
Do
you want to save it till the end?
We can save it
when we're dying out.
Yeah, when we're frying out.
I want to get your guys' thoughts on the Brittney Griner situation.
Well deserved.
I'm not familiar with it.
Okay.
Where you been?
No, not everybody is.
Hawaii?
I've been out of the country.
He's been in Hawaiian Islands.
How long did that boat ride take, by the way? Is there a direct boat ride from Colorado Hawaii?
We got
to
stop.
Took him 3 weeks
Easter
one
Island.
Way because he had to paddle the whole way.
Yeah, there's
it's a canoe.
There's a stop in Easter Island, then Midway Island, and then we finally get to go to Hawaii.
There you go.
Nice.
It's been a long trip.
Are there still kamikazes like on the way? Do you have to avoid those?
Yeah, we got to avoid those. And
are you torn on that whole situation because you're part Japanese? Were you cheering? I know you weren't alive, but in retrospect, were you cheering when you're watching the old videos?
Yeah, I'm American. So yeah, I was cheering them on. No, I'm American. No, and this is a fact that so they call them Niseis. It stands for second generation. The first generation of Japanese to come over were the ones that came from Japan, right, to work in the plantation. The Niseis are the ones that were born there. So they're American. You know, they're considered American, Japanese Americans. The Niseis, after the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, they wanted to go fight the Japanese because that's their land. I mean, this
is that when land. We put them in camps?
Yeah.
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 Well, that sounds
so,
right.
So, but because Hawaii's their land. That's their home. And it got invaded. You know, whether they're of Japanese descendants or not, that's not the point. It's they invaded our fucking land, you know. They wanted to go fight them, but of course, it'd have been a mistake for the U.S. to send them there. And then they can be mistaken for the enemies because they look like the enemies, right?
Right.
So they sent them to Europe. And actual fact is they're called the 442nd Regiment. I think I talked about this in the past podcast, but they're the most decorated unit in the military service, U.S. military service.
Hmm.
Most of them, they had something to prove, right? Because they're looked at as the enemy because they look like the enemy.
Yeah.
How come you never see any of those folks when they talk about oldest living veterans?
Yeah, because every single one of them are still living. And they just,
you know, drink their tea twice a day. Senator Daniel Inouye, he passed maybe like 5 or so years ago. He passed away. He was a senator, U.S. senator for Hawaii. He was one of them. He got a Medal of Honor. He doesn't have a right hand, I believe. He lost his right hand.
That sucks.
But
it's like a whole new sense of training I would have to do with my left hand.
But,
I mean, if it was me.
Please demonstrate.
What kind of training?
Please demonstrate.
I would just be, it's like watching a left hander right. It's just, it doesn't look right. This fucking thing. Leave me alone for crying out loud. Anyway, God, I hate being famous.
Anyway, the Brittney Griner story. She's a WNBA, possibly the best.
Oh, fuck.
Now you know.
That's all you have to say, right?
No. So this is what went through my head when he said Brittney Griner. I'm thinking Britney Spears and was some kind of fucking sex scandal that happened. The Griner. Brittney Griner. That's what I was thinking. It had to do with Britney Spears.
What a fucking weirdo. Anyway, okay, do you know the story?
Yes, I do.
She's stuck in Russia. Pled guilty last week or this week.
Yeah. Hey. Plead.
Had THC caps, whatever, for her pen.
Mm-hmm.
And now everyone's upset that she hasn't been attempted to bring back yet. But
how's the oppression there, honey?
She also refused to stand up for the anthem
mm-hmm.
several mm-hmm. times.
Yep. Very outspoken about, doesn't like the want to stand up for the flag, doesn't respect the anthem, you know, all this.
Mm-hmm. It's a very oppressive country we live in, fellas.
Yeah.
So, but she's learning otherwise right now.
And the reason why she was there is to play a basketball game. That's reportedly she's getting paid $2 million to go play in some exhibition game.
Yeah. So part of the outrage that I've been seeing online anyway is, well, if she made more money like the men do, and I think we discussed
We've had
the WNBA before about how it's
mm-hmm.
held up by the NBA. Basically, they actually lose money every year.
Yeah.
But how LeBron James can make $40 million a year, she only makes $220,000, and if she made that much money, she wouldn't have to go over there and play.
Well, what kind of lifestyle does she have that, you know, $250,000 salary is not enough?
You think those THC capsules are cheap? What kind of heathen are you?
Yes, that's true.
Well, okay, so if you went over there knowing that shit's illegal over there, why would you even run the risk?
So she said she had no intention of breaking the law and accidentally packed them.
Oh, yeah, I've seen this a million times on Cops. It's not my car. I don't know. What we found this freaking, like, what's that?
I like that episode when they find drugs in the guy's pants. This is not my pants. It's like, what the hell?
Exactly.
What, you just woke up?
Well, when you're a crackhead, you just put on any random pants you might see. Exactly. You're going for the first one.
So don't give me the shit she didn't know. She knew damn well.
Okay, so let's just devil's advocate here. So just suppose
I'm standing ground here. I'm gonna be a heartless bastard.
Just supposedly that was true. She forgot. Okay, but is she in jail unjustly?
Unjustifiably?
Here's what I'll say. I do think with everything that's going on in the world, she's probably getting a harsher treatment because she's American.
Yeah.
And maybe. I am a little bit disappointed because if I'm over there, I would hope to hell my government is trying to get me out. It doesn't feel like, although she did plead guilty, there's got to be something to that to speed up the process.
Yeah, that's what I heard. That's step one to get this whole,
to get her kind
do
of,
do like a prisoner exchange. So
yeah, but they want like some psycho murderer guy.
Yeah.
And we want someone that won't stand for the flag.
Some
I think it's not a good trade.
Well, okay, so let's say we get her out of there. Do you think she'll stand for the flag after that? If America
she'll criticize
effort.
How long it took, because they're already doing that.
They're
already criticizing that it's taken too long.
I think she won't. I think, she's still... Okay, because you look at it in the first place. Why would someone not stand for the flag?
Because they're saying that they're oppressed.
Their racial aspect is what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they believe that. They believe that. This is not going to change it. Yeah. This is not...
Though she went to a country and she was treated poorly?
But with that view on how things are, this is what your country, the U.S., is supposed to do for her.
Yeah, and if it was Trump... Trump didn't let Americans just... remain prisoners. Yeah.
He did bring a lot home quickly.
Yeah, but this is what, in her eyes, I'm making this shit up. I'm not her, but
no, but I agree.
That's what I'm looking for, is your input. Like, what do you think?
In her eyes, this is what the country is supposed to do, and if they're not moving fast enough, is because of her skin color. You know,
and I say it's U.S. government never moves fast enough.
Yeah.
So I don't know, man. We'll see.
Yeah,
if she comes back home, she might sit there and go, "That really sucked." You know, this a lot of countries won't bail you out at all. They'll just be like, yep. "Screw it, we don't care if they head you on national television."
I mean, I see all the comments and memes and whatnot online, and yeah, I mean, they talk about what she did, like how she disrespected the country and all that. You know, that's like,
and now you need your country's help. But you know what? California does this shit all the time, just as a general state. They burn up all their money. They badmouth the country. They go, "Hey, government, give us more money."
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's all over the place.
And this is what
it's not just narrowed down to this one person. So.
So.
But how privileged are you to be able to do that? You know what I mean?
Very.
Yes,
but
it's not
thing
the
is like
best,
you, these
but
are
it's
the
best out there.
These are the mentalities that you can give and give and give and give to. It'll never be enough. Ever.
And this is what...
but we'll see. Maybe she'll come back and have a change of heart. I don't know.
It won't happen.
In this singular case, I can sit there and say maybe.
I don't think so. Like going back to... Okay, just say everything about this country is true on what she's saying. Like, it is racist country. Mm-hmm. You know, the government hates minors. Whatever her reasons.
Yeah.
Just say it is true, okay? Number one, it's not the country that does that to you. It's not the flag that does that to you. It's people. It's the leaders. But they don't protest the leaders. They don't go and speak about how the president's not doing anything, senators are not doing anything, governors are not doing anything. They sit for the flag. Or they're not even present when the national anthem playing. But it's the country that gives you every opportunity to do the best you can, you know, in your career, in sports or whatever. This country, like everything, all doors are open here. Mm-hmm. The country provides, I don't know the exact word, but
opportunity,
the opportunity for that.
It's
but yet, because it makes a bigger spotlight. Hey, look at me. Look what I'm doing. You're on national TV.
I think we're in the social media age. Yeah. I think
but
that's
the problem is because there's so many agendas being driven. Okay. So you have, I'm all for equality. Okay. I'm not for equity. There's a big difference there.
Yeah.
Okay. So, But then when you talk about equality, equality of opportunity, I'm for. Equality of outcome, hell no. It makes no sense.
No.
Because I'm going to give you sit there and that's the guy who, you know, that's the whole analogy of the professor that says, you know, I'm whatever the average is the grade you're going to get. And you're going to have the lazy people who sit there and go, I'm not studying. You're going to have the people who go, why should I study so hard? And then everybody fails.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what you get when you get an equality of outcome. Everybody fails in equality of outcome. Equality of opportunity. Everyone's got the same opportunity, but you got to go out there and do the fucking work.
Yeah.
So, and I do believe that this country, for the most part, is equality of opportunity is already there.
And honestly,
for in some cases, because obviously you get in inner city and you're raised in that, and that's what you see, and that's how your brain is programmed. You don't think that the equality of opportunity is there. And if you're stuck in that position, the opportunity isn't there. And I agree with that too.
Well, and on the protesting front, you know, people give a lot of praise to people that, you know, the Muhammad Ali's that stood up, that risked everything. And I look at, and I'm not against LeBron James standing up. And, but at that time when Muhammad Ali did what he did, he stood up and said, I'm risking being destroyed. Now the kind of the thing that you're supposed to do is stand up and naysay everything. That's the expectation. So are you really risking anything by doing it? So I really think there's not the risk there. People reward people based on, oh, they're putting it online, but are they really? Because they're actually going with what the narrative says they should be doing.
I mean, he went to jail. I mean, in his prime, right?
Oh, yeah. So, in this country, destroyed. And that's why he's, you know, boxer, whatever, number one, is because he put up with all the stuff that he could have, still performed, still did, you know what I mean? He did. Mm-hmm. Mentally, he had a harder road than, and I'm not saying people don't have a hard road now, but when you're just going with the grain, the expectation is that you stand up and naysay your country and naysay this and talk trash about that.
Yeah.
Are you really risking anything? You're not, you're actually risking something saying the opposite.
Yeah.
So
like celebrities, right? They, you know, like you look at Hollywood and you automatically think, okay, the bunch of libs, it's because that's all you hear from celebrities, you know, the liberal point of views and all this is because the conservative ones do not want to speak up.
Yeah.
That's their career.
There's a couple of them.
So, couple of them have, and they got somewhat, cannot totally cancel.
No,
they got a lot of hate.
Yeah, if you're a box like office,
Chris Pratt, you're only going to cancel so far.
Yeah,
because we need him as.
But you know what he does? So. He does it respectfully. He does it with class.
Yeah.
And so they have a hard time canceling him because he's not crazy.
Again, it's
going Ted way Nugent. Right. Yeah.
It's not Ted Nugent stuff. No, but I mean, it's a whole culture that we're building here that I don't know. Okay. Think about when you were a kid, like, what did your parents tell you? Like you grow up, you can be anything you want, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now we're at a point where we grow up.
Not with Asian parents.
What's that?
Not with Asian parents.
Well, okay.
Doctor, lawyer.
Yeah, no.
You're such engineer. A disappointment.
I know.
I know. Yeah. You really disappointed. For the most part, as
your
a kid,
poor father,
you're told you could be anything you want.
He's rolling in his grave.
You're encouraged to take a path, right? It's not. Now they teach kids because of who you are, because of the color of your skin, or because of whatever, you're being held down, and they're creating as if we don't already have this huge generation of victims.
Built-in excuse.
They're creating in more victims. Mm. And you're not going to build a country or be a strong country
if you're
a bunch of victims.
You got to build the people, person.
I told my son this a long time ago. A real man is never a victim. You freaking choose. Am I a victim or do I learn from this opportunity
and
move on?
And you look at it and you push through.
Yeah, exactly. And you learn and you...
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm getting a little bit, you know, a little bit fired up over it, but it's a shit you see now and it's unacceptable.
So one example I always like talk about, you grow up poor, whatever, you're in a shitty neighborhood in the city, in the urban city with gangs and all this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's got to be tough. I grew up in the suburbs, but if you look at Asian immigrants that come to this country, don't even speak the language. Right? In one generation, they're out of that urban neighborhood.
Indian. One, well, I guess that's Asian too, right? Indian,
Korean, there's certain, Vietnamese. And you got to say why. They're in the same neighborhood as other, you know, people in that economic bracket, you know, living with, you know, gunfire at night, you know, gangs, same neighborhood, but they're able to get out of there in one generation. Yeah, it's because the Asian parents would drill it to him. You're here, you're, so where they come from, right, so everything's by class. You got the peasant class and then you got the upper class. That's it. Mm-hmm. Everything's by class. There's no way to get out of the peasant class. You know, there is no way.
Did you make
way.
Fun of them as a kid?
All the time. No, but when they come here, they come to America, there is a way now. There is the way to be in that upper bracket of income. There is a way when you come to America.
And you buy a liquor store or a dry cleaning.
Yeah.
Or a restaurant.
Yeah, a restaurant.
Is that stereotyping or is that true?
That's true. I mean, that, if you look at liquor store.
Or you become a doctor.
I'm thinking more of like Southern California, right? There's tons of liquor stores, restaurants, you know, they're all immigrants, you know, own them, you know.
Yep.
But that is true. And that's what's kind of drilled in their head, you know, when to their kids is like grade school, you got to be a doctor, you got to be a lawyer, you know, you got to be some kind of profession where you make a lot of money. And it happens. It's not that, at least you get a college degree, get a good paying job. And within one generation, they're able to move out.
But I think that, and I'll buy into this one too. When you look at the inner cities and the black community, they have been wrongfully targeted ever since Lyndon B. Johnson, for sure.
Yeah.
So, and Margaret Sanger. And what happened is they turn and they make all these people seem like they're good people. And now, next thing you know, the whole, I mean, Lyndon B. Johnson said, I'll have those ends voting Democrat for the next 200 years. And he's proving it.
Yeah.
He's proving it to be true. Why? Because slavery was wrong. And, you know, all these Republicans and conservatives want us to be back in chains. And like, well, wait a minute. We took you out of the chains. The Democrats kept you in chains. You know, let's put it in perspective. Let's study our history. But and then look at the crime bill. How many fathers got removed from those inner city households? They weren't so much inner cities. What party's in charge of those inner cities?
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're trying. That's a race that's got, I think, that's being purposefully held down because
that is true.
They can manipulate them and use them
if they believe what they hear. Yeah, but there's a lot of them that they actually think for themselves.
Oh, absolutely.
And they get out of there.
They're not widely publicized either because they don't want them all to know.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I see. The Asians, the only, like, don't get me wrong. Every race at one point in time has been persecuted pretty much. So
that could be part of the reason too, because like when the Asians come over, they don't speak the language. So they're not going to be on social media. They're not going to be watching the news. They're not going to be listening.
No, they're going to be busting their ass is what they're going to be doing. So
that could be part of it.
But I don't know. This is just a big bill of goods that's being sold to this country, and it's not correct. So I could take the tinfoil hat off now, I suppose, but I don't think I'm that far off. But whatever.
Yeah. How we get on this topic?
I don't know.
You're going to have to cut it down, and it's going to only be like eight minutes of
topic. Because you're talking about the chick who, well, I don't know. And again, let's see what happens. Maybe she'll come back.
I'm going to go change my shirt about this again, and we'll pretend it's a new week.
I think that, though, her beliefs are due to her being, you know, very misinformed. It's not necessarily that she's an idiot or she doesn't know what she's doing. But I will tell you this. If I'm going overseas to a foreign country to whatever, make eight times my income, I'm going to make sure there's nothing in my bag that's going to screw me. So,
and
I don't know that that's an excuse.
I mean, just suppose you forgot.
Suppose you did.
But with me, what would be going through my head is like, oh, fuck, you know, my bad.
Yeah.
My bad. Fuck.
Whatever. It's interesting. It's good for critical thought. Not necessarily good for podcasts where a bunch of guys are fucking off though. So, you know, whatever. Let's see. So where are we at? We on the trivia or what? We got to wait for,
I don't have buzzers.
We got to wait for Felcher to get out of the bathroom there.
I don't have the ringers. You got to use your phones.
Oh, it's not going to be a multiple choice. You're going to get one guess with this because the guesses are going to be so out there.
Okay, give me the answer while Justin's in there so I can make it look stupid.
Okay.
Stupider.
So the first one is just going to be goat poop, okay? So, all right. Okay, that's the first one.
It's true. Yeah. First one's true. Second one's false.
First one will be goat poop. So, how's your beer?
It's empty.
Oh, okay. You
want another one?
Since you was.
You done with yours?
He's all shit.
You want another one?
Yes, please.
Oh, you going to make it to work tomorrow?
I don't know. I've got like, I think it's.
You don't have any more shirts that fit.
You're wrong because I got the 3XLs coming in the mail.
If you just wear the same shirt like you do every week on the podcast.
Beer doesn't make you fat, dude. You'll be fine. Beer doesn't make you fat.
You know what makes you fat?
What?
I don't know.
You're fat.
You know what makes me look fat?
Red makes you fat. What was that on? I can't remember. Look, you're making Al anxious.
I am.
Oh, my goodness. Well, because we're going to play trivia now. All right, so...
Al sucks and
you
don't trivia.
Even you can't even look over my shoulder and see the answers because it's the show I answered won't. You.
I'll look over here at Al's.
Well, some of the answers are so outlandish that you get one guess, but you can take as much time as you want to think.
Okay. As much time as we want?
Maybe not as much time. Maybe not.
Could
as much
I go
time.
Home and think on it?
No. Okay.
Text them at
what's
three
the time
morning?
Limit? What's the time limit?
Just whatever it feels like.
Okay.
Wrong.
Too long.
Wrong.
Okay. Number one, ancient Romans boiled vinegar and what to make an energy drink?
Urine.
Goat poop.
More information. The sports drink of choice of ancient Roman charioteers was believed to improve their performance in the arena. How did you know that? You must have been a charioteer.
I drink goat poop.
He's pushed in some goat poop in his day.
Actually, I could play this game too because I didn't I can't see the answer either until I click show answer.
Okay.
In Tennessee, it's illegal to drive if you are what?
A woman.
That's what I would think, but I would say
no, of course that's not true. You get another
it's
guess.
It's illegal to drive if you're blind. Legally blind.
Yeah, it'll be something stupid like that. Like, okay, so you say legally blind.
Not a human.
I was going to say ostrich because there's none of them there. It would just make no sense. Okay, let's see what the answer is. There's no answer. So, no. There really is no answer. What the frick? Okay.
It's
answer. Oh, it's illegal to drive if you're asleep. Sounds reasonable, especially considering
fish using a lasso.
Sounds reasonable, especially considering that Tennessee law also makes it illegal to catch fish using a lasso. Yeah.
Okay.
That's the only way I like to fish.
I'll keep that in mind when I'm in Tennessee.
Yeehaw.
Yeah. what was banned in Indonesia for stimulating passion?
Rhino horns.
I'll say oysters.
Oh my God, this is so much pressure.
Why? Because we both have answers and you don't?
Chicken beaks. I'm going with the animal theme.
It'll probably be correct. Come on, show me the answer. Hula hoops.
Oh yeah, those are hot.
Oh yeah.
In 1958, Japan and Indonesia. Thanks a lot, Japan. Okay, 1958, Japan and Indonesia banned the public use of hula hoops on the grounds of public indecency. It sounds like something the Japanese would do.
Yeah, it's like very the most much perverted people.
Fucking asshole.
No, they are because they're the most restricted. Have you ever watched like the Japanese porn? They all got blurry genitals.
Yeah, no, that's what it looks like.
They're actually
that's
blurry. They're actually blurry.
That's what I'm saying.
If you do that, you can actually see
but
it.
But the men's blurs are really small. The blur on the men's are small.
Yeah. It's like one pixel. One pixel blur.
In fact, it's not even blurred.
Well, no, but even at, okay, so when you're at night and you hear like some people being wild outside or, you know, get obviously drunk or something, it's always dudes. Like, it's never chicks. It's very much a man's society. I mean, you'd probably agree with me.
Shogun. Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Washington police officers get a half hour class in how to what?
Washington, how to roll a joint.
Ooh, that's a good one.
A half an hour class on what? Washington police officers. Oh my God, this is ridiculous. There needs to be hints.
Yeah, I know. There is no hints because it could be anything. We can stop after this one.
Test for marijuana intoxication.
Okay.
Tiki-talki, tiki-talki.
I know. I'm trying to think. It's going to be something really dumb, like how to put your patrol car in gear or something. Get a half-hour class on how to... All right, securely fasten their gun belt.
Okay.
I don't know why I got to click show answer twice. Okay, you ready for this? Sit down.
A class on sitting down?
A half hour class on how to sit down.
So are they standing the whole time?
It probably has to do with all the shit hanging off their belts, if you think about it.
Mm.
And the bulk, if you got a nightstick, I don't know, whatever.
Okay.
And by the way, it doesn't say Washington State or Washington, yeah. D.C.
Just says Washington.
Maybe
says
they do Washington. A lot of anal on that police force.
Look, could be. The employees of the... Oh, Seattle. Okay, it's Seattle. Didn't they just change that to CHOP or CHAZ or something like that recently?
CHOP.
Okay. No, the employees of the Seattle PD fingerprint unit were required to attend mandatory training on how to use rolling chairs after three people filed compensation claims for injuries sustained... after attempting to sit in one. You see what you fucking freeloaders do to our society?
Yeah.
And the taxpayers pay for this shit? Damn. If you're going to file compensation claims, at least make it reasonable.
I'm going to do that at work.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Here's a wild guess. Americans do what 22 times a day?
Get on their phones.
22 times Americans.
Check their social media.
You think so?
Yeah, on their electronics. 22
times. I think people look at their phones more than 22 times a day.
22 times a day.
Probably more like 10 times that.
Not all of us work to home, Mike.
Dude, I probably look at it less because I work from home.
22 times a day. What the fuck do they do? Drink. It's actually just one time is over 22 hours. 22 times a day.
So you say get on social media.
Social media. 22 times
or
a day.
Or check their phones, whatever.
Yeah, log on somewhere.
Say fuck this job.
It's going to be something simpler than that. Like sigh. I just sigh. 22 times a day.
All right.
Okay. Let's see what the answer is. Open a fridge.
I just open it once and then clean it out while I'm standing there.
And then there's nothing. And then you know there's nothing in there.
Yeah, there's nothing in there.
I do that within like 30 minutes thinking things are going to change. Like.
Is there anything good? Nope.
Nope. I guess I'm not eating today.
Let me check again.
Yep. Trying to figure out that light stays on the whole time.
This is surprising considering that Americans eat 20% of all meals in their cars.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What is fitted by Argentinian scientists that helps increase milk yield?
What is fitted?
Yeah, what's it mean by milk yield? Actually, what is fitted?
By Argentine scientists.
Argentinian scientists that helps increase fitted. Milk yield. I imagine on women that are lactating. That's all I can think of by fitted. Increasing milk.
Bras? Yeah. Did they like fit the bra a specific way? What is fitted?
Chest binders. I don't know.
Nipple ring.
All right. We're not going to sit here and think about it too long. Come on. False teeth.
Huh.
Okay. Oh, we are talking about cows. No.
They did false. Oh, so like it's you can take heifers. Them.
Cows' teeth start to show wear after around 5 years. Dentures help them live longer and healthier lives and produce more milk. That was
so like you take them out when you go suck their teats. Yeah. Is that what happens?
Yeah, exactly.
No teeth.
All right. This one's funny. I mean, I guess. Probably. Besides Amber Heard, what is Johnny Depp afraid of? It just says, what is Johnny Depp afraid of? But.
Running out of cocaine.
What is that? Right. Scissors.
Spiders or something.
Pirates. What is he afraid of? I think it's a bug, snakes.
It's a what?
I think it's snakes.
Snakes?
Yeah.
When you say what?
Spiders.
I'll say not enough alcohol. Because he drinks mega pints of wine, remember?
Dry bar.
He calls them large glasses.
Clowns.
Huh.
I think everyone's got some fear of them. There was that whole epidemic of like guys who just, people would stand on the side of the road looking like a psycho clown.
Yeah.
You'd probably get shot if you come up to my car window.
That was happening until people started fucking kicking the shit out of them.
And everyone's like, oh, this isn't a good idea. The actor has coulrophobia, a fear of clowns. Coulrophobia? Anyway.
Pennywise.
All right. What's the main ingredient in Bombay duck?
Duck.
That's what I would say.
Bombay. Maybe that's gin.
Gin.
It could be gin.
Bombay duck. The main ingredients in Bombay
duck. Wouldn't it be duck?
I would say duck. But you know what? That's probably too obvious. Yeah.
Just like, what am I thinking of?
It's probably lamb or something.
There's
stupid.
Like other dishes or like or drinks that say that, but there's none of that shit in there, right?
Oh, it might be a drink. You're right. You're on to something here.
Bombay duck.
Well, Bombay gin.
It's a drink. So gin.
Gin.
Yeah.
Bombay duck.
I'll go with gin.
Survey says?
Fish.
Mm.
Who, oh.
That's what I said, fish.
There's no duck in the recipe. The main ingredient is fish called some fucking Hawaiian word. I can't say.
It's not English, so it's Hawaiian.
If it's not English, it's obviously Hawaiian or Mexican.
Or Mexican. not Spanish, it's Mexican.
Okay, two countries that don't allow tattoos.
Do not allow.
Mm-hmm.
I know Japan looks down at it, but
yeah,
but they get tatted. The criminals get tatted, the Yakuza.
Yeah,
but like allow, like you cannot get tatted. I think like
don't India? Allow.
I think like Iceland.
Can you get tatted in India?
What
about Pakistan?
I don't.
I was going to think I'm like one of those
Middle East. I'm saying
one Iceland. Of those Middle Eastern dirt worlds.
I think Iceland has some weird strict, like,
even though they have all those heavy bands.
Ooh, what about China?
Could be China.
I'm going to go China and North Korea.
I don't think China cares.
Yeah, maybe some place in the Middle East.
Oh, North Korea could be.
In the Middle East, but.
Unless you get like, a Kim Jong-un tattoo.
Doesn't it have, like, Iceland? I think it's Iceland. That there's a book of names that you can name your baby, and if it's not in the book, you got to get permission. You got to go to this fucking whatever.
You want to name a Deshaun?
Governing body or whoever to get permission, and they'll.
Shanique was not in this book. You have to go to the government on this.
So I'm thinking Iceland.
So you think Iceland
and probably like the Middle East?
I'm saying North Korea is one of them at least.
Iceland and
I can see North Korea.
Maybe India. I don't think I've seen any Indians with tats.
But India is such a massive population. I mean, well, then again, I threw out China. So, I mean, China's obviously the largest.
And it kind of came from the South Pacific, from like that side. That's where tattoo came from. Tattoos came from.
You mean that midget guy?
The plane?
The plane!
Ricardo Montalban.
Smiles, everyone. Smiles. Some Scandinavian country, maybe.
So you're thinking like Norway, yeah. Iceland, what? Something like that, or like Denmark?
I'm thinking Iceland, no. Or Iceland. Denmark. Yeah, because there's like I'm going, no. With that. I'm going with the Viking pattern.
So. You got all those heavy metal bands out there?
This makeup, though. Those black metal bands, they're just all makeup. I'm going with Iceland and Norway.
Iceland and Norway.
You're an idiot.
Switzerland. Iceland and Switzerland. That's the
Switzerland. No,
that's your final answer? Final answer. Okay, I don't know my second one. I will say North Korea, though. You got anything?
I already said.
You finalizing?
India, Pakistan, something like that.
Okay.
It sounds like it'll be one of them.
Iran and Japan.
Iran and Japan. They allow tattoos in Japan. It's just frowned upon.
Well, but think of how the society and the government probably treats it. I mean, as you're automatically.
You can go to Japan and get a tattoo in Japan.
Can you?
Yeah.
Go read the extra.
Okay. All right. Sorry. In addition to tattoos, Iran has outlawed spiky haircuts and sunbeds as signs of devil worship. In Japan, tattoos are associated with, I say Yakuza, you say Yakuza. It all depends on the emphasis on the syllable, I suppose. Or members of the country's organized crime syndicates. So tattoos are associated with
so they're Yakuza, frowned on. Or sounds like
they're just frowned on.
Highly frowned on.
That, but immediately when I heard the question, I was like, Japan's probably one. And then, yeah, you pointed out like, well, yeah, that they are. I mean, you go there with a tattoo, and you talk to people. They're amazed that you got one.
You got if you go to like the bathhouses or the gym, you got to cover it up.
Yeah,
you're not allowed in there. So.
Okay. Maybe the last one's okay. So, which country has 6 villages called Silly, 12 called Billy, and 2 called Pratt?
Australia.
Sounds like Australia.
I don't know.
Pratt. What country or New Zealand? I'll go with Italy, just cause.
Okay. I mean, I can see Australia now that I think about it, I suppose, but I'm going to do something like Russia. That wouldn't make any sense, would it? Denmark. France.
Fucking French.
He's fucking French. No, they also have a village called Cord Nudes, meaning naked body. And then, I don't know if that's pronounced right, but, and then there's a village of Montitan or My Nipple. Fucking pervs. Gosh. All right, should we keep going or you guys got something else you want to talk about?
Go for it.
All right, what were the first ice hockey pucks made out of?
Ooh. Wood, probably.
My mind immediately went to wood, but that seems too obvious.
Steel.
Ooh, probably some kind of bone.
The first one, rocks. Granite.
Road apples.
Granite. What's
some kind of ivory or bone?
Maybe like maple. Maple wood up there in the fucking Canucks.
Yeah, I would think tree first, but then I think
bone, I don't know, and then
because it's light rock. Enough to slide on the ice, but
I'm gonna go with cow shit.
Bone.
You say bone? What do you say?
I'm gonna go with bone, but I think tree is another, some type of wood probably. Because everything starts as wood.
Frozen cow dung. Motherfucker, I got it. I got
Get
it.
The fuck
I got
out
one
here.
Right.
Oh, shit.
Fucking inventing a game playing with cow patties out there on the.
However, most people use stones or pieces of wood. Okay, so there's your backup answers. So all of them would have made it on Family Feud.
Bullshit.
In Florida, it's illegal for unmarried women to do what on Sundays?
Go to church.
It could be.
Unmarried There's been women more outlandish to do shit. What on Sundays?
Unmarried women cannot do this on Sundays. By law. It's illegal.
What the fuck? Unmarried women cannot go shopping. Because married women have to go shopping on Sunday.
I'm going to say go fishing. Fishing. And I don't know why.
If it's fishing, I know you read this shit beforehand.
Unmarried women cannot go on Tinder.
I'm thinking outside the box here, pal. Go to church is like... It would probably be something
just
even more
just fucking pull up the answer already. Quit making up excuses why you already read it.
I did not read it. Skydive. See, motherfucer? Can't skydive.
Why the fuck would you not?
The law is rarely Sunday. The law is is rarely, if ever, enforced. It doesn't give a reason.
I'm going down there. I'm making a big deal about it. I'm going to go down to a skydive.
I know. I'm going
to
go down there.
Oh, are you married?
Officer.
Make yeah. a citizen.
Well,
arrest.
You're not married, so you just go down there, identify as a woman, and then put on a bikini and then go try to skydive.
Done deal. Wouldn't be the first
time
I dressed
up. We're
going
to start a GoFundMe, folks. We're going to get Justin to identify as a woman and go skydiving on Sunday.
It wouldn't be the first time I wore
Florida.
A dress.
Okay, so what establishment has a lower acceptance rate than Harvard?
Lower?
This podcast.
It's everything.
What it's establishment?
What establishment? So it's probably not another college because they use the word establishment. Has a lower acceptance rate than Harvard.
U.S. government.
Fuck. What do you think?
Oh, lower acceptance rate. So it's harder to get into this.
Yeah. Harder to get into it than Harvard. Establishment. That's what's throwing me off.
Astronauts.
Okay. That one's good.
Astronauts.
Anything, Justin?
Some kind of golf club. I don't know.
Some kind of golf club. Okay. Golf.
Skulls and bones.
If it has anything to do with golf, you win this one. I'll go.
The society. Nobel.
Do you want to go with Nobel?
I'm going with my astronauts. That. It's hard to get.
Top Gun Academy.
I'll go with like Golden Globes or Oscars, some kind of actor award, something.
Anybody can get into
that. Okay, let's go.
Anybody can get into that, though.
But it has the lowest, I don't know.
What the fuck?
It says Walmart. More information. Harvard may have a 4.6% admittance rate, but Walmart has 2.6. I don't understand what it was asking then.
Probably honestly. Based on how many people apply.
Yeah.
There's some trick motherfucking questions in here. Okay. Oh.
Lambskin.
That's what I was just thinking. So... It's almost too obvious, though. Okay, sorry, Al.
Condom.
What was ancient contraception made from?
Yeah.
Immediately you jump to lambskin. Are we all on a consensus with that?
Yeah.
Your looks.
Right. Rhino horn.
Crocodile dung.
That's crocodile dung D?
Ancient Egyptian women would mix crocodile dung with sour milk to form a thick dough. Which was inserted into the vagina as a sperm barrier.
Like a
you know what? I'm not even going near that thing. Once
yeah, you definitely weren't licking that cat.
Yeah.
This tastes like shit. God.
I mean, ancient Egyptian women, they got a lot of crocodiles in Egypt. What the frick?
Yeah, the Nile crocodiles.
Yes, of course. I forgot. All right. Well, we can keep going, but we can find better topics, too. I got to find better trivia is what needs to happen.
Yeah, that's terrible.
Those are tricky. I mean, at least give us like multiple guests.
We lost four viewers.
Yeah.
Four subscribers.
Sorry, guys. I probably drugged this freaking thing out. Because this will go on for 100 freaking questions, I think.
Charlie's deflating. It was so bad.
His neck's crooked. His neck's broken.
He's bored.
Tanya did that sexual assault on him, so he hasn't been right since. So.
His knee's been wrong way.
That trivia is way too hard.
He runs. Yeah.
There's 202 questions.
Go to the very last. What's the last one?
Who is the quietest Disney princess?
Sleeping Beauty. Because she was sleeping.
Good answer. It almost seems too obvious, though.
It was Snow White, right? Who bit the apple and fell asleep.
Who is the dead one?
Sleeping Beauty.
I don't even know.
Princess Mute.
Yeah. Whichever one couldn't talk.
Aurora. Aurora is the quietest princess because she barely speaks in Sleeping Beauty. She has less than 20 lines in the whole movie and was on screen for only 18 minutes. You said Sleeping Beauty first. All right. Well, what else we got? Anybody? Should I go look for something else?
What do you got, Al? What do you got?
Nothing.
What do you got?
Nothing.
So we can spend the next 20 minutes talking about how I repaired the roof on my shed yesterday.
Okay.
I got some hammer nails. Some
flex tape.
Because a giant tree branch.
Flex seal.
Giant tree branch decided to fall off the tree above it and puncture it.
Your tree or the neighbor's tree?
My tree. It wouldn't matter if it was a neighbor's tree.
And they don't have money.
It's an act of God.
They're just going to laugh at you.
I had this conversation before because the neighbor's tree fell over from his yard, took out because my power lines come from above, ripped the entire box off my outside of my house. So I had no power. And the insurance wasn't going to cover it.
Just your house. Act of God.
Yeah, because it fell over.
Sure, somebody just didn't throw the branch on your roof?
I did, however. Well, it was during that snowstorm in 2018. That crazy one we had.
Yeah, a lot of
the only thing that saved me was I told them, I invited them to come look at it because they neglected that tree and it was dead for a long time and it was ready to go. And I said, come on out and look at it. They neglected it. That's their fault. So they ended up paying for it.
Nice. Their neighbor's insurance?
Yep.
Pay for it.
But they weren't going to because they said when a tree falls, it's an act of God, whatever they want to call it.
Everything
doesn't matter whose yard it's in.
Punch someone in the face.
Actually, you guys paid for it because it's USAA.
Oh, motherfuckers. That's how my rates went up.
Oh, you have USAA?
No, he did.
Oh.
You guys don't have?
It wouldn't have mattered if it was the neighbor's tree or not.
Well, you have USAA, right, Mike?
No.
Why not?
I bank with them because they're freaking expensive. Outrageously expensive.
Yeah, I've heard that. They're insurance?
Don't get me wrong. If something goes wrong, they'll probably ask zero questions.
I don't think they might not be the cheapest, but they're not expensive.
The best part about that whole electric box thing was my house was built in 1956. It was the original box. So it needed upgraded. So it was kind of a blessing.
Yeah.
I was super happy because it was on my list of things to do. And then the neighbor paid for it. I was like, check.
Yeah. I see some of these questions caught my eye, but anyway,
you guys know any trivia just off the top of your head?
How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
22.
That was easy.
Mythbusters already proved that.
You're terrible at this.
Yeah.
So you ready to go back to work, Al?
Oh, I can't wait to go back to work.
Have you not been back since you've been back to America?
Yeah, Thursday.
You know, if you come from a foreign country, you don't have to work anymore, right? Yeah, I
do. I'm just waiting for my visa.
Don't you have to quarantine for 2 weeks?
Yeah. No, he's got a vaccine. Yeah. He's good.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't go to Hawaii because I don't have one, so.
Yeah. Actually, they opened it up.
Did they?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going before they close it again.
I would say everyone should visit Hawaii at least once.
You think your mom will let me stay there?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Freaking Annie would probably let you stay at her house.
Oh, well, yeah,
she's,
Annie.
She's,
oh,
there's Annie. She's throwing that
did
one.
Did she watch this?
Did you visit her?
No, actually not this. I only saw my friends one night. We, you know, met at a bar and some shit happened at home. So I actually had to leave early. But I mean, I got to see my friends at least. But yeah, it was more of a, it wasn't more, it wasn't really a pleasure trip.
Yeah.
So when you say something happened at home, you mean your anxiety kicked in? You're like, hey,
and I gotta go. I knew you,
were
guys,
doing that dropper like this.
I knew you guys since I was 6 years old, but fuck, I'm it's
probably
the anxiety.
Mother-in-law battle.
You couldn't handle the sexual tension anymore.
I could not. Yeah, I just wanted to have sex with my friends. My
no,
boy,
but
my,
Annie,
my male friends.
Andy's always been like, yeah, come on. I mean, shit. Now we haven't asked in a while because Tanya and I were like, we're gonna come out there. She's like, come on out.
That'd be an option.
She's like, you know, she'd pretty much be our tour guide.
I'm assuming this shit, but knowing her, even if like she couldn't get time off or whatever, she would still tell you to come and just use her place. And
yeah.
You guys do whatever the fuck. You guys play tourists, you know?
Yeah.
No,
she's always been that kind of person, so. But, very cool. Very cool.
Definitely.
So, yeah, I got to get, I really do got to go out there. Tanya's seen it. I can't let my wife see a place I haven't seen before.
And every place is there.
You mean like her vagina? You haven't seen that yet.
Yeah.
Somehow. You just need to get one of those Schwann's uniforms and you'll be in. You'll be good.
He doesn't work for Schwann's.
Yes, ma'am. I'm the new guy. So did you guys do any celebrating today?
What is today?
It's Prime Day.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Gosh, yeah, I got to buy something.
Well, wait a minute. Should I mention it's July? So it's Ultra MAGA month. So come on, guys. Should be celebrating every day this month.
Is that an actual thing?
Yeah.
This is speaking of,
it's like Pride Month, but it's Ultra MAGA Month.
It's the opposite.
Yeah. So I mean, but we don't throw parades and temper tantrums.
So there's one.
Walk around naked.
You probably know this, but not everybody knows this. Trump had the first openly gay member, I guess, on his cabinet, but the media never did talk about that.
Pence was really?
Yeah, you didn't know that?
It wasn't Pence. There's no way.
No, I forget what he's Department of Transportation. I don't know. I don't know what he did, but he was the first openly gay member in the U.S. cabinet.
He wasn't flamboyant enough.
But the media never spoke of this.
Yeah. Of course they
won't. Was he like that guy from Mannequin, the guy at the store?
Hollywood.
Hey, Hollywood.
Hollywood.
How do I remember that?
That was life-changing for you.
That was a great movie.
One of Us is in a movie
Didn't
now.
Didn't they have Mannequin too?
I believe so.
That would have fit right into our better than
the opposite, right? The Mannequin was a male.
Better than the prequel.
Yeah, it was like the opposite.
Better than the first one.
The store clerk
was that his name, Hollywood?
Yeah, Hollywood was it. Yeah, I remember Hollywood.
Hollywood.
R.I.P. Hollywood.
The freaking sunglasses.
Assuming you're dead, I don't know.
The different sunglasses Hollywood would wear.
Yeah, but, you know, supposedly, you know, Trump's.
Well, that's a full-on, in the Biden administration, that's a full-on qualifier because, I mean, look at the press secretary. She says, I'm the first gay, black
woman. Minor, well, black, yeah.
Yeah, it's like, there you go.
She was a minor?
Yeah. Nicole, she worked at Pennsylvania coal mine. Isn't she an immigrant, too?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Probably. But these are all the qualifiers to be good at your job.
What about that trans testicle? Isn't there like a trans testicle that works in the Biden administration?
There's a sextratory
of state.
Yep. Trans testicle.
No.
I forgot that chick's name.
Yeah, there is one. I'm not sure what
Eric.
What she does.
Her name's Eric.
It's ma'am. Told you to call me ma'am.
I'm sorry, but that's a funny looking motherfucker.
Well, that's probably why he tried.
I wish she would show up on my Tinder account, because
you've been looking for that kind of woman.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's one of those that you won't even know until going after they pull their fast, pants down.
Folks, going downhill fast.
Yeah, we're getting canceled.
I wish you would go downhill fast.
Let's see. Secretary of...
So, you guys know any trivia off the top of your
head? Okay, here's one. What color was George Washington's white horse?
He did not have a horse. It's a trick question.
Wrong.
Secretary of Health.
That's what it was.
Rachel Levine.
Okay.
What's the original name?
This dude goes by Rachel Levine. I'll show you some pictures here. My computer can speed
up. Oh, man, I'm going to need to use your bathroom.
I'll let you borrow the laptop. Slow enough.
Trans testicle doctor Rachel Levine.
Watch this. Okay, I'll give you some pictures. I'll give you a nice visual.
Why did it say Rachel Levine's wife was one of the search topics?
I think he was married before.
Yeah. Admiral Rachel Levine, MD.
This is terrible.
Oh, no. Take medical advice from this.
Scroll down. I want to see the original.
From this day.
Well, I don't know which one's worse.
Before and after, you don't know which one's first worse? I don't know either.
Oh, that's hideous. I don't even care. They can cancel me. That's terrible.
It's all about looks for you, Justin. Come on.
That looks like a Halloween costume. So like you're not even trying. Like
that's your Top Gun nickname, Shallow.
Like the whole point is to really look like a girl.
On a scale of 1 to 10 of Halloween. Quality Halloween costumes, that's a 1.
That's a negative. That's fucking terrible. I'm not a guy.
It's ma'am.
Reminds me of Saturday Night Live when they were at the mall. I'm starving.
But I mean the irony. Yeah.
Oh my God, I love these fries.
Lay off me, I'm starving.
You love him so much. Lay off me, I'm starving. Why don't you marry him? Aren't you on a diet?
Yeah, Cindy.
That's but exactly I what she looks like.
I love that too.
It like, was Adam Sandler.
And off me, I'm sorry.
So you say your name is Cindy Crawford? Well, not the Cindy Crawford.
That's terrible. She could be in that skit.
Actually,
you fucking grab David Spade's shirt. Lay off me, I'm starving.
Chris Farley dressed as a woman is way hotter than that.
when he was the lunch lady.
I'll do Chris Farley first, actually. So
Sloppy Joe, Sloppy Joe.
Sloppy Joe. Yeah.
Well, we'll be signing out for the last time tonight, people.
No, we're not getting canceled on this.
No one watches this
shit. Dude, nobody watches this
shit. We'll be
shit.
More popular. We need to be more provocative. Al, stand up and show your penis.
All right.
That's your provocative.
I'll whip it out. There's nothing to see. If I show it, you guys will be like, where is it?
Well, they don't know that. You just stand up and do it, and then we'll put a giant blur mark over where.
Like going to my knees. All into my knees. All
right. That looks exactly like it. Holy shit.
Sloppy Joe. Sloppy Joe.
I know it says here that your name is Cindy Crawford.
Yeah, but not the Cindy Crawford.
God, you gotta miss that guy, right?
Serious. Oh, here's a fact, trivia fact, but he was not a stand-up comic. He was one of the few SNL members that was not a stand-up comic prior to SNL. Almost all of them did stand-up.
Okay.
But he was,
I'll take that.
I think he might be the
one. Did Belushi do stand-up?
They all did stand-up. I think he might be the one.
Because he and Belushi had very similar, to say their demise was very similar.
Were you offended when Belushi played the samurai?
Yeah. Dude, but he made sandwiches. So it was okay. It was a samurai sandwich maker.
What was it called? What was that segment called? Something samurai?
I don't remember.
Yeah, Belushi samurai.
Yeah. Oh, can you cut this in half?
I'm a Belushi samurai deli.
Samurai deli? Samurai. Samurai deli. I can't even say deli without saying deli.
You know, you can never find either, like I was searching for one day. Saturday Live stuff is hard to find, but the Scoutmaster one, you can't find that
Cantina
one.
Cantina Boy, whatever.
Yeah.
Really?
Was that Alec Baldwin or something?
And Sandler. Yes. Sandler.
Oh, they had the one with Chevy Chase and Richard Pryor calling each other Reese's names. Oh, yeah.
They said that you got worked up in that one.
He really did.
Yeah, they said he did. He really got emotional in that
Who did what? Chevy Chase and what?
And Richard Pryor. Richard Pryor was a guest on SNL, and they're going into this.
It was like racial thing back and calling. Forth.
And who got worked up?
Honky in the N-word.
Yeah, Richard Pryor.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Like he was interviewing him for a job N-word. Or something.
Yeah.
Oh, I figured because Chevy Chase, I think, as he got older, turned into a bigger and bigger asshole.
No, but it was on the show.
So I thought it would have been him.
I thought it was like it was in a skit. They must have known what
it was.
Going on.
But I think they got it was yeah.
They went beyond what the script was.
I don't know if they went beyond it, but it was supposedly he got worked up.
Now, what was and then of course always like Norm MacDonald acting as Burt Reynolds. And then you had what's his name is Alex Trebek, or not Alex Trebek, Sean Connery from Jeopardy.
Yeah.
Those two guys.
Or with Norm MacDonald after the OJ case verdict. That dude kept making reference to OJ like nonstop.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And they kept telling him to stop, and he just kept doing it.
Yeah.
They kept telling him not to do it.
Yeah, on the news section.
Yeah,
right,
the news one.
You always throw something in about OJ.
Well, there's some dead shit you're going to have to cut out. About half those trivia jokes, if not all of them, or trivia questions.
All of Mike's racist comments earlier in the podcast.
What are you talking about? There's nothing racist about it. This is probably one of our more serious ones, so you're going to have to chop the shit out of it.
We need more alcohol in these podcasts.
I'll bring the whiskey next week.
We do. We got way too serious. Yeah. I was sitting next to Tom Brokaw and whatever over here.
Tom Brokaw drinks Natty Ice every night. Everybody knows that.
Just reporting the news.
Bob and Walters and shit.
Yeah.
Bob Walters.
No, I get that comment. I heard it from a few people said that whiskey drinking one was one of their favorites.
You my guys brother drank that, whiskey?
That we should keep drinking.
Was I there? Yeah, you drank most of it. That's why you blacked out.
This sounds like most marriages, like talking to your wife.
Well, like I said,
it's not fun unless you're drinking.
So you guys don't have work tomorrow, right? I mean, well, when we do it on Monday nights, you don't have work, do you?
Let's not act like you work hard at work, Mike.
So then, no, I'm not. I'm saying that you could crash here if you fucking need to. And yeah,
just leave the cameras on and we can hang out and record the whole thing.
You're working from home or you're actually going
in? No, I went in today.
Oh.
Freaking came home and Justin's in the freaking house. Probably. You know,
with a swan shirt on.
Yeah. Going after my wife.
Yeah.
I saw it.
Oh, she was after me.
You had to fend her off.
I did.
Okay. I got
okay.
it.
Yeah.
He's such a klutz in the bedroom. That's all I kept hearing. I was like, okay, just keep it going.
Yeah, I understand.
She did tell me, though, that I have some groupie out there. Apparently, she said that somebody she knows thinks I'm super funny on this show. I don't know if it was a guy or girl. It doesn't matter.
It's a guy.
It's a groupie.
Definitely a
guy. You're the comedian.
It's because I'm fat. Fat guys are funny. I'm like Louis Anderson.
That's why I'm trying to get fat, but man, it's coming on slowly but surely.
I don't think any one of us could be called anorexic or anything like that. But
no,
we got rid of that one.
Yeah, you are the comedian.
Yeah. I do still want to do that. I need to write some material up and go.
There you go.
And I'm not inviting you guys to the show either.
Good. I'll write some for you. I want to do
you guys
that.
Will fucking heckle me.
That's nah.
You can't, I probably would.
You can't heckle. That's such a fucking dick move to heckle a comedian. Because, like, number one, even if you know him, number one, everyone's there to watch the guy on stage, not to fucking listen to some guy in the audience.
Right.
That's number one. Rule number one, man. Don't fuck.
That's why I would employ you to heckle me.
Okay.
As part of the show.
And get kicked out.
Oh, to fake how brilliant you are? Like, I had all the answers.
That's actually on my bucket list, too.
I think that's a good plan. We'll bring you up, and I'll heckle you, and then you can storm off, and then I'll just go up there like, fuck
take
it.
Over. Like, I don't even start. It's like, hey, ladies and gentlemen. And you're like, boo, right off the bat.
Fuck you. And they walk off.
And like, motherfucker.
I'm trying to think. Bill Burr, I watched him on a recent interview, and it was like a podcast or an interview you wouldn't think he'd be on, but they kept bringing up the things like, well, like that bit you were talking about where he's like, fuck, he's in Philadelphia. He's like, fuck you guys. It's like 6 minutes left.
Yeah.
And
he's that's
running out the clock.
Yeah.
And he says he never watched it. He felt so embarrassed about it.
Yeah.
And he's like, after that, he's like, oh, fuck it, my career's over and shit like that. And ended up like everyone thought it was hilarious. Yeah. So then he wasn't even going to do the show the following night. And it was somewhere else and frickin' there on the East Coast, probably in Pennsylvania. And then he wasn't even going to do it, but they went up there and immediately booed him because they're like, we want him to do that shit to us. He's like, all of a sudden, like, he's like, but I didn't want that to be my following. Like, and I got to study, find out what the shittiest parts of all these cities are, you know, because everyone's going to want me to bash their city. It was freaking funny, but yeah, he talked about how, like, he's like, when you have jokes that fall flat or people start booing, he's like, you got the attention, so they're listening even more, but, you know, it's the wrong kind of attention. You just got to learn how to shift that around.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, all the times he talked a lot about all the times he bombed it. Like, if you're going to get on stage, you just got to accept you're going to bomb
true.
It a lot.
I mean, you talk to any of the biggest comedians out there.
They're the biggest bombers.
Fucking bomb, yeah.
So many times.
What you're saying about Bill Burr didn't want to watch himself after, a lot of them are like that. I mean, you look at their background, they all come from fucking, what's the word? my fucking brain. Fucked up homes, you know. They all come from fucked up homes, abuse.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
usually humor is a way of dealing with reality, right?
You say like fat people are funny, like Kevin Smith said it. You know, he was fat in school, and so to beat the other guys to the punch, he would start making fat jokes about himself.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
it was like 8 Mile.
Yeah, yeah. Then and once you start doing it, they have nothing. You know. They have nothing.
Yeah, I do it all the time because people are like, hey, you know, hey, yeah, man, we think a lot alike. Were you ever in the military? No, I was just in the Air Force. Because you tell people Air Force, like, hey, fucking pussy Air Force guys, Air Force, blah, blah, blah. You know, but if you just disarm them real quick with that and you catch them off guard.
And that's how it comes. I mean.
But absolutely. I don't know. Like I said, these guys are they talk about how to cope with all that. And yeah, they bombed the biggest. He talked about how he even got started in comedy. So
yeah. I mean, a lot of them came from low income homes, you know, you know, it's parents divorced.
But I mean, you think about Bill Burr too. He's very cynical, but it's the way he delivers that cynicism. That's so damn hilarious.
Yeah.
That gets you laughing. So I don't know. Good comedian. Fantastic comedian.
Broken Home. Yeah, one of my favorite.
Definitely.
Faves.
So, you got it. Yeah, don't forget your bumper stickers.
Putting that on the back of your car.
Pride month. I don't even own a car.
Pride Month?
Oh, your wife's.
Pride Month was last week. Oh, yeah. Go ahead and put it on there. I'll tell her it was Justin. You'll never be allowed in this house again.
No, because she thinks she'll be like, oh, that was so funny.
That's true. That's true because you're not her husband. It's like, honey, here's how you do this.
I wish Mike had a sense of humor.
Step one, you do this. Step two, you do this. Step three, you do this. No, I'm going to go. And then she'll be go talk to her friend's husband or something. He's like, you know what this guy said? You know what so-and-so's husband said? He said, step one, do this. Step two, do this. I'm like, that's what I fucking told you. Like, wives never listen to their husbands. They want outside opinion. The husbands can't possibly know what's going on.
I mean, you are on the least successful podcast in all of the neighborhood.
I am. So, she gives me credit for that. But I mean, know, this is fine. my main income earner, so.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. So, you don't have to be, man.
Oh, man.
It's freaking bought me a lavish lifestyle.
In your mom's basement?
In my mom's basement. Mm. She bought all this lighting She's and the so camera proud. Equipment, too.
She's so proud Everything. Of her boy.
She bought all this shit. Thank you.
But it's all right. She's gonna leave it to us in the will. Don't worry about it.
$1.
It's ours anyway.
That's why you're constantly yelling during the meal. Mom, just leave the pizza rolls on the counter. I'll be done in a little bit.
Just drop the Hot Pocket already. Anyway.
Mom, we're recording. Damn it.
Now we have to start all over again.
I always do this when my friends are over. God.
All right, I'm calling it. That's long enough.
I know, yeah.
Holy shit.
87
minutes of shit.
Yeah, we might be able to siphon off about 7 minutes.
Probably have to split this in two.
Yeah, probably.
You can hear the toilet flush?
No, that's the freaking AC turning on. Oh. Take off your headphones, numbnuts.
I just heard, I thought it sounded like the fucking toilet.
Yeah. Your wife just took the biggest shit ever.
And she named it Justin.
She was like this upstairs. Mike, oh, I need some toilet paper.
She would text me.
You know what? So my mom has a bidet.
Oh, fuck. I got to go. Hold on. No, Tanya just texted me.
Don't forget the toilet paper. My mom has a bidet. I'm fucking kidding. I've been using that thing.
It's like a Japanese thing, dude.
It's So like
Japanese
if someone's using the bidet bathroom and the other bathroom's open, I would wait for the bidet. The first time I use it, so I don't know if you ever use one. This is the first time I ever used one.
Never.
But you can adjust the
angle.
The position. The
front to back or side to side.
So the first time I hit it, you know. Yeah.
Or you can go swirly.
Squirt it up your shirt.
Dude, I learned all this shit in Japan because every freaking toilet in Japan has this.
And then, it's fucking the water's heated, you know? It's like warm. You know, it's not
Is
hot,
her toilet
hot,
seat warm. Heated too?
Can be, but I never used that.
Okay. You probably don't need it.
Does
it wipe
up when you're done? Does like water get?
Well, so.
You dry your ass off with toilet paper.
So
man.
I fucking hit the water.
I mean the seat.
Well, no. Everything, it's clean, you know?
No, dude, your freaking ass is a gasket on the seat. It keeps it dry.
Everything's out of the way. Like where the dude, water comes badass. Out, everything's out of the way. It's not like it's right on your fucking butthole, you know. But so I fucking hit the water and I hear it and fucking just comes out fucking bullseye right in the fuck. I'm like, oh,
right in the
fuck.
Brown eye.
And I shut the thing off. I'm like, holy shit, that's not welcoming. You know, that's like, no.
You need to turn the water pressure down, mom.
Yeah, you can adjust that shit too. And then I had on the lowest setting and then. Okay, let me try to fucking adjust the position. So I adjust it all the way back and hit it. Okay, so it's off of the fucking brown eye. And then I slowly creep it up and I fucking go. And then I'm moving the fucker back and forth. I don't know how dirty my ass is. So I'm just covering the whole range, you know.
It's going to pressure spray the back of the butt flap and everything. Yeah.
I'm on there like fucking, you know, 30 minutes fucking just rinsing my ass. And then next there's a fucking air dryer fucking dry it. No, I never used a dryer the first time. But so I just shut it off and like, I don't trust this thing. I never use it. So I grab the toilet paper and wipe it. It's fucking just soaked wet, but it's clean. So I'm like, whoa, shit, I got a fucking air dryer. So I air dry it, sit there another 30 minutes, air dry, then I fucking wipe. It's like, fucking clean. The toilet paper's clean. So I put it back.
You're like, I'm going to get my ass. So I put it
back. No.
So it's like, folded up neatly for the next person.
You're like, this is how they eat ass.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dude.
So probably like the first 5 times I use it, I wiped after. Because I'm like,
is this consecutively?
I never left that room. So I'm
I gotta go to the bathroom.
I'm busy.
Oh, you just got out 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, so after about the fifth time I stopped wiping, I'm like, okay, this thing is doing what it's supposed to be doing. So I'm getting one. I'm getting fucking
Are
getting
you really?
One. Yeah. And you
so
don't, you
would know, you don't say those ones attached to the seat, you can buy the seat that has it?
It's
those
basically
the same
thing? It's the whole seat.
It's like a really thick seat. Yeah. And it's got this arm that folds up. So and it, like at my hotel room had it. Freaking Sony Computer Entertainment Fab had it everywhere you went. They had these toilet seats that were heated. They had a freaking bidet arm that came out. Yeah. And yeah, you have spray options: swirly, straight, pretty much.
I had a oscillating
pulsing.
So you go,
yeah,
it'll do that shit
when you get that last nugget hanging, and it's like it's gonna fall it in,
and everything's out of the way. So like so that so here's like the toilet seat, right? The horseshoe. Like that, the openings on this side, right? And everything's like on the back wall. There was like two doors. I'm assuming one's the water, one's the air. But there's two doors. They're closed. But when you hit the button, I guess the door opens and then the fucking stream comes from there. I don't know if something comes out.
I don't know that I got the
there's
air.
There's a guy on the other side.
It's a little Japanese guy on there with a...
I don't
pressure washer.
I don't think I ever had the air treatment. So yeah. Where's the air come from?
But there's two doors. I didn't see it
compressed.
That guy opens the other door. He's like,
yeah. The control's on the side. It's on the side. So I guess there's a pump in there.
There must be a pump and a tank.
Oh, yeah, and yeah, a fucking fan or something. But
the guy is in there like
with a straw, with a fucking straw. He's in a little fucking water gun in a fucking spray bottle. So. But anyway.
Yeah, it's a definitely. Good experience.
And so you don't have to, you know.
You said, you know, you didn't have a good time in Hawaii. This sounds like this was a great
That's all
time.
I saw. Was yeah.
No wonder you stayed at home the whole time. Is that the situation that you had going at home? You had to leave the bar?
You're sitting there barring it up with your friends. He's like, I got an emergency.
I had to take a shit. And
warm water.
I can't
asshole.
Use any other toilet.
Just a wee hint of ass sweat, and you were like, I got to go home and clean.
Nah, it was awesome.
I got to go do a rewipe.
I don't know what you guys like after you shower. Like, I try to shit before I shower, but sometimes that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
And then after I shower, like within like an hour, and if I'm at home or whatever, and if I have to shit right after a shower, I would jump back in a shower and wash my ass out.
Really?
I don't know if you guys ever do that, but like, see, with the bidet... With a bidet,
you don't have to worry about that.
You can do both at the same time.
Just jump in the toilet.
You wash your hair in there.
Yeah, fucking corn. It's pieces of corn.
So I do the opposite. When I gotta take a shit, I just jump in the shower. And I just press that shit through the grate like a Play-Doh fucking press machine.
Two birds with one stone.
Yeah, and then you're like, hey, I got the corn is still here. I can just make that for dinner tonight. Strains it out.
So.
So like you know,
no, they actually are, surprisingly hygienic.
Yeah, and with you know TP shortages, you know, happening. So
yeah, you got to.
Yeah,
you
but it doesn't help the water shortage.
Yeah, but TP, you don't have to use TP to even dry it off if you got a freaking hair dryer under your asshole. Yeah. So you're good. I mean, it's gonna be pretty clean. It may not be as clean as it is if you do.
Shit. We're like. Over 30.
It's past my bedtime.
This is going to be two episodes.
I don't know that it's going to be two episodes because there's a lot of fucking boring material in that. And I'm disappointed in us, fellas. You guys didn't bring enough to the fucking table this time.
Hey, I bought the Georgia Guidestones, man.
Can you CGI another shirt on me at least?
I'll just blur you out. Then the whole podcast.
Blur out his whole face.
Change my voice.
Mike and Al podcast.
Blur his whole face. This is our Japanese cocksucker this week, folks.
Yeah.
You can tell he's got the same genitals.
Gok Gok 3000.
It's like Gok Gok 3000. Hanging out with my friend Bidet Al.
Hanging out with my friend Al Bidet.
Al Bidet. Yeah.
All right. Wet well, ass. Whatever you guys want to do.
Rock me Albadeus.
However much time you want to spend in front of the editing, Al.
Not much. I forgot how to do all this shit. But okay, yeah, we got to be out. All right.
Well, remember, all for right, fuck's sake.
Remember.
Okay. Peace.
Remember.
We out. Peace.
Peace out, dogs.
Yeah. Okay, we out. Bye.
Probably would still have a job if all he did was yell at that person.
Yeah. I think the fact that he was pushing his door back.
What he should have done is grab the license plate, know who it was.
Hey, go to welcome to the conversation, Mike.
Go to security. Go to security.
We talked about this.
Oh, sorry.
Jeez.
Well, hell,
come
man.
Come late and repeat everything that was said. I love it.
Dude, I was in the bathroom. Okay. This didn't fill me in on what you were talking about.
We were talking about
not
that,
fair.
That Gok 3000.
You guys already start the podcast?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're like 30 minutes in.
I knew it. I was busy napping. You didn't wake me up.
You know what's weird is when we do the best of, it's all the times you're in the bathroom.
Excuse me.
What are you doing after the show?
Gok 3000.
Hey, we need to actually record some of this.
It's been recorded.
Well, I know.
But everything's running.
That's what it's going to sound like when we actually have groupies waiting for us outside after the show.
Ooh. Yeah. Right.
And it's just going to be the paper boy. You'll be like, no, okay, you can't.
The Swans guy.
You think they're there for that? You're just sexually insulting some random person.
Can I get
person.
Back on the podcast? So they come in, they're doing Clerks 3.
Really?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
God, Clerks 2 is gross, grotesque enough.
Yeah. I'd watch
Somebody mentioned to me the other week where, like, have you ever seen the original Clerks? I mean, yeah, it's great, great flick. And they're like, I'm out. I thought it was cheesy or something like that. And I go, well, it's a low budget freaking film. The guy didn't have any money. I mean, for what it was. What it was worth, it was funny.
Yeah, it does not stand up.
I am the master of the clip. Remember this fucking face. Whenever you see clip, you'll see this fucking face. I made that shit work. No one rules a clip like me. Not this little fuck. None of you little fucks out there. I am the clip commander. When it comes down to business, this is what I do. I pinch it like this. Oh, shoot, little fuck. I am the master of the clip. Remember this fucking...
Fucking Jay. Gotta love Jay.
Yeah, it doesn't stand
just
up.
Just so you know, that's in but my photos. That's a video in my...
It's saved in the...
But it's like...
First date.
I post it online whenever I'm trying to get some.
First date material.
That's right.
Or it's like
tell me a little about yourself.
But yeah, going back to Clerks, for what it was, being low budget, the humor in it was great.
It was the dialogue.
I mean, I still walk around and like Olaf's song will, come on, Olaf, just sing. It's like, that's his fucking metal face. My love for you is like a truck berserker. Would you like some making fuck berserker?
Did he just say making fuck?
And then it's like, cuts to a couple other scenes and comes back to him. He's still doing it really good. My love for you is ticking clock by Zaka. Would you like to suck my car?
You know what's still funny though? Office Space.
Yes. That was opposite.
Hey Peter, turn it on channel 9. Check out this chick.
So I watched that when I was in college.
Which one?
The office space, and you know, was Mike Judge, right?
Are we even start the show yet?
Nah,
Michael Bolton.
So, I watched it just because of Beavis and Butthead, right? I watched Office Space, and
I'm gonna get some whiskey.
A lot of that shit just
didn't appeal to me because I'm in college. But after I started working, after college, I actually started working for a corporation, then all of that shit was funny.
You should try working in an IT department.
I want
the knife.